Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. You may recall from the previous update the critical geometry that I discussed early on. Two planetary peaks with Mercury, Venus and Uranus, 90 degree angles. And that there was a 75% probability of a magnitude 6.5 or larger earthquake. And indeed, as you can see here on the SGI graph, magnitude 5.6 and larger, we had a 6.4, 6.5. Following that geometry, it was on the 26th at Vanuatu. We also had a magnitude 6 at south of Fiji, and that happened right in between when that planetary geometry occurred. And overall, on this SGI graph, you can see the relationship between the larger, or let's say the seismic increase, and the occurrence of critical planetary geometry. These are the red and purple peaks, and we see this repeatedly. Then we also had a planetary conjunction with Venus on the 27th, and that was followed by a clustering of stronger seismic activity to magnitude 5.9, borderline 6, and then on the 30th, early this morning, a 5.6 off the coast of Guatemala. So this relationship between critical planetary geometry and increased seismic activity, usually the clustering of stronger earthquakes, is very evident. In the coming time frame, up until August 8, we have a convergence of planetary conjunctions. This is going to be critical planetary geometry. That's Mercury, Venus and Saturn in a conjunction. That will be tomorrow morning, and it will be followed by Mercury, Sun, Uranus later tomorrow. That is a near convergence of two planetary conjunctions, both involving Mercury and Venus, and that is going to be critical, especially because it will be followed a day later by a full moon. We had a similar situation on February 4 and 5. On the 4th and 5th of February, we also had two planetary conjunctions, both involving Mercury and Venus, including Mercury, Sun, Uranus on the 5th. It was followed by a full moon later on the 5th, and then we had this major seismic activity in Turkey on the 6th. This is a similar situation, probably equally critical, but it very much depends on the condition of Earth's crust, the stress levels in Earth's crust, whether or not we're going to have a major seismic event. It requires a larger fault section, 200-300 kilometers, for a major earthquake to occur. And whether or not that is the case, that is the question. We cannot measure the amount of stress, but we can look at the planetary geometry. And if there are, if there is a fault section with critical amount of stress, this kind of planetary geometry and lunar geometry combined can trigger and will trigger larger seismic activity. But I do expect at least a seismic increase. How exactly, again, that depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust. Watch the coming days. We have a convergence of two planetary conjunctions followed by a full moon, and we're going to have strong tidal forces as a result, and we're going to have a seismic increase, but it depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust, how strong that's going to be. We also have Mercury, Earth and Saturn in a conjunction. That will be on the 2nd. So from the 31st of July to the 2nd of August, we have a near convergence of planetary conjunctions with the full moon on the 1st of August. Then we have lunar conjunctions on the 3rd and 4th with Saturn and Mars. And as we can see, Mars is now well beyond the geometry with Saturn, the lunar geometry, that is. And then later on August 8th, we have Venus, Mercury and Mars in a conjunction. That's going to be a critical conjunction, and that will probably be the marker of a critical time frame, because in the second half of August, there is the potential for a mid-8 magnitude earthquake due to a clustering of planetary conjunctions approximately from the 11th to the 19th. That's the period that there will be very critical planetary and lunar geometry combined. But let's focus on the next few days first. There can be major seismic activity, strong to major seismic activity, following the convergence of planetary geometry involving Mercury, Venus in planetary conjunctions, followed by the full moon on August 1st. This is going to be critical. On the website, you will also find atmospheric fluctuations. We didn't record many fluctuations. On the 25th, we had a couple of fluctuations over the East Pacific, also marking regions near Central and North America. But if you draw a line to the south, it could be South America as well. We don't know. It is an indicator. and it can be off. And on the 26th, that is the latest fluctuations that we recorded, that marked regions in the Indian Ocean, and there was a seismic increase there, 5.6 and 5.9 right there. And also the regions to the north, there may be some seismic increase or larger seismic activity. If you count about 6, 7, maybe 8 days, there is a higher probability of increased seismic activity in the Eastern Mediterranean region, maybe the Middle East. This is an indicator. There is no certainty in this respect. So watch the website for the latest updates. We will update that regularly. Other than that, we cannot really pinpoint exact locations. That is still not possible. And this is because it depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust. And that is the one thing that we cannot measure. So we have to go by atmospheric fluctuations. They can be significant, but it certainly is not 100%. So if you are in an earthquake prone area in the coming days, be on extra alert. There is the potential for a major seismic event following the convergence of planetary and lunar geometry from the 31st, that's tomorrow, and then on August 1st, the full moon. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.